Today's video, we are super lucky to have Danny Hatcher here on Keep Productive to dive into how he uses Morgan for tasks and calendar. Now, Morgan's a fairly recent application. If you want to see the review to it, we've done it and we've made it in the link in the description. But this gives you a working example of how somebody is using Morgan for balancing both situations. A big thanks to Danny Hatcher for coming on. He has a fantastic YouTube channel, which you can find in the link in the description. Thank you very much, folks, and make sure to join us here on Keep Productive.
While I'm on my PC working, I use a global hotkey to open up Morgan to check I'm doing what I'm meant to be doing. I can go backwards and forwards in days with the arrow keys on my keyboard, change the view with D, W, M and Control 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0 for a 10-day view, pushing D, then T to go back to my today view. Going back a day with the arrow key and pushing Control 3 gives me yesterday, today and tomorrow for a quick planning and reflection session, or when planning bigger, I head to the month view with M and use a pre-made calendar set to filter out or filter in the calendars I want to see. Pushing 1 on my keyboard shows me all of the events and tasks, 2 shows me events, 3 brings up my content calendar, 4 my research calendar, and 5 my action tasks. 0 is for all my calendars and shared calendars linked to my Google account. Pushing space brings up my tasks that don't have dates yet or are overdue. I can add, sort, filter, or move them onto the calendar for scheduling. To move to any date, I can use the calendar picker at the bottom and jump straight there, adding an event in the day in the appropriate calendar, or making it a task that can be ticked off and completed. Hi, for those of you that don't know me, I'm Danny. I am an internet academic researching educational science online with free resources. Normally I'm talking about philosophy, psychology, education, or productivity related science, but Francesco asked me to talk about Morgan, my task and calendar app of choice. What you just heard was a snapshot overview of most of my use cases in Morgan. All of those features that were mentioned are completely free, but now I want to take you through the app a little bit deeper, discussing some of the other features, settings, and options Morgan offers. I want to mention at this point, I do know the team behind Morgan because I've been beta testing and bug finding the app for over a year now. So this is biased, but I don't earn anything from what I'm going to say, and my words are my own. Taking a step back to look at Morgan in the week view, there are the all-day tasks and events at the top, the week schedule in the main view with the days in the past being grayed out, and the current day is slightly larger than the other days. This view and all the other views can be changed at the top, allowing you to hide or show weekends and completed tasks, widen the current day, and also merge identical events from different calendars. As I mentioned earlier, I mainly live in the day pop-up, but by clicking on a day in the week or month view, I can jump straight to that day, narrowing in for planning. For me, the interface is really nice. It allows me to drag tasks and events from the all-day section to the day I want, or from the day to the all-day section. I can change the event start or end by dragging either the start or the end. I can also unschedule a task for the day, putting it back into my task list. A task has a tick box that can be ticked, but it is also hollow, I guess you could say, whereas events are full of color. The event color is the color of the calendar they are in, which can be fully customized. The task color is a mix of the calendar they are in, but also the task list they are in. My green tasks are all habits in the habit calendar, but the green task in the all day has a red start line, which is the content calendar. So the task outline is the task list, the task color line is the calendar. This is helpful in my content calendar as I can see the content I need to do and the content I've created with the different colors, green done, red not. The green are in the task list, the red are in the inbox. And obviously, the posted content is hidden as they are completed tasks. The difference between a Morgan task and event is mainly seen inside of Morgan, as Morgan is like a costume around my Google Calendar. A Morgan task in Google Calendar is seen as an event that is identified by the tick emoji. I don't look at my Google Calendar anymore, but if I do, I know what are tasks and what are events. A task, once it has been scheduled, has most of the features an event has. It is in a calendar, plan, start and end, repeating options, so my repeated tasks or habits can be put in Morgan. and an estimated duration box, which I don't personally use. It then has a due date, which can be different from the planned end. It is the due date that the overdue task section looks for, not the planned end. So I only put a due date on high priority tasks, like project deadline tasks that keep me on track. Because these tasks are like events, you can change the status of a task and add notifications. Each calendar has unique notification settings. So if a task is in that calendar, they get those notifications. My action calendar has a 5-minute notification, my habits a 10-minute notification, and my events and content both have a 1-day notification for all day events only. So I'm reminded the day before. This helps me keep on track during the day so I don't spend all of the day doing one thing or forget to do something really important. There is a priority tag, but again, that is something I don't personally use. In the general settings, you can change the default calendar. I have mine set to actions because that is where all my tasks go, but it can auto-select the most recent calendar if you want. The time zone and regional time format can be changed. The first day of the week can be changed. The initial view and the theme, be it dark or light mode, can be changed. Changing the day grid start and end time is helpful to really focus on the time of day I want, so I don't have to scroll down each day because not everyone wakes up at 6 a.m. in the morning. The display resolution is basically how big the blocks of time are, and the dragging resolution is the jump distance the blocks move when you drag to reschedule them. The day limit is for the all-day events and tasks shown at the top of the day, week, and month view. I start Morgan on my PC as a startup and use the open sidebar as the global toggle because I need to check what I'm doing at the beginning of the day, otherwise I could go in literally any direction. Now, this confused me a little bit to start with, but you can link one calendar account to Morgan in the free plan. So I have one Google Calendar account linked and have as many calendars in the account as I want. You can see I have a fair few. That calendar account can be any sort of account, as you can see in their website. If you want to link two calendar accounts, then you need the personal plan, and any more than that requires the pro plan. If you can link your calendars together before putting them into Morgan, you can stay on the free plan. My sister is at university and has her university calendar in Outlook because university, but uses Google Calendar. She has synced her Outlook calendar with the Google Calendar and linked the Google Calendar account to Morgan. You can also see here on the pricing page that if you want to use integrations, you need either the personal plan or pro plan. The other differences are scheduling links and branding on the booking page. But before we get to that, there is another difference, which I do use quite a lot, the added time zones. When I hover over the time, it shows me what that time is in the selected time zones, which makes checking the time really easy instead of searching the time in whatever place over and over and over again. The free plan gives you one added time zone, and the personal and pro plans allow for 10. So inside the settings, there is an availability tab for selecting the calendars that you don't want to book over. I have my events calendar and John, my podcast partner's calendar, selected in case we want to book a guest. I can make sure it doesn't clash with John or me. The booking page is the page that people will be directed to if they click on a link, or the embed that shows on a website, like on mine. As it shows in the settings, removing the Morgan branding is a pro feature, but brand color and logos can be added to the page. You can set up permanent virtual rooms with Zoom, Google Meets, etc., and add the room directly to a meeting instead of having to find a link, attach the link, and go through that hassle every time. Adding the room is on the free plan. Or if you are on the pro plan, you can integrate to Zoom and have it generate a new meeting link for you. The search feature in Morgan is one that I don't often use, but when I do, it is so fast, just like Obsidian, and I can find any future or past task or event with ease. And for those of you wondering about a mobile app, it is amazing. As a paying member of Morgan, I have access to their mobile beta, which has tasks, the calendar, syncing, all the basics, and it is being developed all the time, so if it doesn't have what you want now, it will do soon. The calendar sets at the moment are not on the mobile app, but when you open the menu on the PC, each calendar can be added to any number set. Then pushing the number filters out to the calendars you want, as I mentioned earlier. I have tried to cover as many of the features as possible in a fairly short video, but with the rapid development of Morgan, I'm sure there will be new features out by the time this video is published, and my workflow will probably have changed. If you're interested in my Morgan workflow, I have a section in my course all about it from setup to daily use, or you can look through any of my work in my online notes. They are all linked on my channel and on Twitter, which is my main social media platform. Thank you, Francesco, for having me on the channel again. It is always fun talking tech.